الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. So inshallah ta'ala, we continue with the risala of Imam al-Mubajjal, Imam Ahmed ibn Hanbal al-Shaybani رحمه الله تعالى. And the risala of course starts with أصول السنة عندنا, the foundation of the Sunnah with us, التمسك على ما كان عليه أصحاب رسول الله عليه الصلاة والسلام. So the foundation of the Sunnah with us are holding firm to the way of the companions of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wassalam, taking them as an example, taking them as an example, where Imam Ahmed have taken this statement from. Where this statement has been derived from? We spoke about it last week. Which hadith? The hadith al-iftiraq, the hadith of al-iftiraq. Na'am, barakallahu fik. So the hadith of al-iftiraq, the ummah was split up into 73 sects, all of them in the hellfire, except one. They said, who are they, O Messenger of Allah? He said, one on today, and my companions. That's one. What is the other hadith? Where is the other hadith that this statement is being taken from? نعم بارك الله فيك أحسنت عليكم بسنتي وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين. That was upon you to follow my sunnah and the sunnah of the rightly guided خلفاء. So this is the, and we follow the way of the صحابة. ليس بالقول or just be, with إيمان. Like a مرجئة. You just believe in the text, but you don't implement the text. No, you have to believe, when you say Sahaba, implement that methodology of the Sahaba. And to know the methodology of Sahaba, the manhaj of Sahaba, is in these books. The Usul Sunnah, Imam Ahmed ibn Hanbal. Sharh al-Sunnah, Imam al-Barbahari. You never hear a Salafi, someone from Ahl-Sunnah Jama'ah, bringing doubt about these books. Those who try to bring doubt about these books, either Sufi, Khurafi, Maturidi, Ash'ari, Naqshbandi, you know, Ahl Bid'ah, with Dalal, people with guidance and innovations. You know, someone who يُعَظِّم كِتَابَ اللَّهِ وَسُنَّةَ الْمُصْطَفَى عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. Not the person that glorify the book of Allah. The book of Allah has yaqiniyat, certainty. And in aqidah, not dhaniyat. Not unclear. In aqidah, but likewise a sunnah and the way of the sahaba, so you implement it. Sharia al-imam al-ajuri iban al-kubra wa-sughra ibn batta usul sunnah al-imam al-abi bakr al-ismaili sharh al-sunnah al-imam al-muzani. There's too many of them, and this person, may Allah guide him, in Birmingham, he started making videos bringing doubt about Shrah Sunnah Imam Barbahari. Miskin. Allah Musta'an. And calamity of YouTube and calamity of social media, allowing everyone to talk. You know, ahmaq, miskin. If he's a time for a Sahaba, he will get lashes for it. Because he is misguided. Salaf is only follow one book, Shrah Sunnah. Shrah Sunnah is, there's too many books. Aqa'id, alhamdulillah, this Imam Salaf have written too many essays and books in aqa'id. Barakallahu fikum. So, following the Sahaba, no, you say you Salafi, al-Hadith wal-Athar, say, yeah, I accept Shrah Sunnah Ibn Barbahari, also Sunnah Ibn Ahmed, but you don't implement it, you cooperate with everyone for the sake of unity. Okay? So we have to be careful. So, ishtinab al-bid'ah wal-hadar minha, Because Sahaba, first, like, as the Sheikh Rabbi mentioned, Sahaba understood the Quran and Sunnah correctly. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised them. Na'am, we spoke about ijtinab al-bid'ah wal-hadar minha, staying away from innovation and misguidance. Innovations, al-bid'ah wal-hadar minha, stay, leaving off innovations, for indeed every innovation is misguidance. And we have spoken about that Nabi alayhi salam used to warn against innovation during his lifetime when there was no bid'ah. There was no bid'ah. During the time of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. But yet he used to warn against it. And he used to shout on the minbar, warning against the bid'ah, because bid'ah is dangerous. And if people of bid'ah and innovations, they leave off the clear verses and the clear ahadith, and they go to unclear verses and clear ahadith. As in Nabi alayhi salallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you see the one following that which is not clear from it, then they are the ones whom Allah has mentioned. So be aware of them. So be aware of them. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, so as for those in whose hearts there is a deviation from the truth, they follow that which is not clear thereof, or entirely clear thereof, seeking what? Al-fitna. So we mentioned Sheikh Salah al-Sheikh Hafidhah wa ta'ala, mentioned Kishf al-Shubuhat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is adl. Allah will not misguide you if you're seeking the truth. But those who misguided, they were only, generally speaking, they were already looking for fitna. They already have disease in their heart, sickness. So they go to unclear verses. They go to unclear verses. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَالَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ فَيَتَّبِعُونَ مَا تَشَابَهَ مِنْهُ. So those who have disease in their heart, they go to unclear. There's, as the Sheikh Muhammad al-Wassabi, Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, al-Wassabi, one of the ulama of Yemen, he died, rahimahullah ta'ala, and may Allah have mercy upon him, may Allah forgive him. He have written a risala, I think, there's, or they had a lecture, 100 ahadith about hearing and obeying the Muslim leaders. 100 ahadith. Yet the Khawarij will leave that and they go to unclear hadith, unclear verses. And we will speak about later on, inshallah ta'ala, about the Sam'a wa Ta'a. Naam, so also we've spoken about the statement of. We spoke about this one, Naam. Naam, leaving off also. Debate, not sitting with the people of desires, and it is to abandon debating and the argumentation in the religion. And the Sheikh have explained there's two types of debating. There is a praiseworthy debate and a blameworthy debate. Praiseworthy debate and a blameworthy debate or discussion, you name it, or dialogue. So the first one, the blameworthy debate. Do you want to know, should I give you a living example of a blameworthy debate? Ali Da'wah with the Prophet. That is not a debate. That is a comedy show. That is a blameworthy debate. That is not debate. That is a living example of what is a blameworthy debate. If you don't call that a blameworthy debate, I don't know which one is blame. It's so clear. We know that a man is a liar, evil, kadab, khabith. This individual, this respectful person, if you know that what you are inviting him to debate with him, if you know that his man is going to mock Allah and his messenger openly, but yet you are giving him the platform to do so, this man is known, he's been doing it for many times. You know, eating grapes and Allah al-Musta'an. I mean, the man, alhamdulillah, some Muslims dealt with him. Some Muslims have refused him, exposed him, humiliated him. So why you have to speak to him over and over again? Why you, even the mubahala? Mubahala, he said, yeah, I'm tricking you. But he's mocking you. So you are allowing him to mock Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. You are giving him the platform and the justification to mock Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by doing this. You know, he said dua. He went like this, he started mocking. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Or debating for the sake of showing off, wal-iyadu billah. And na'am, sometimes in a discussion or dialogue or debate, you'll be tough. There's no problem with that. There's difference between being tough and being clown. I hope people understand. Being tough doesn't necessitate being clown. You know, there's a difference between tough, strong, and please stop embarrassing. That is a mushkila when you have Muhammad Hijab as a teacher. Taking one, the hadith, the author of Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. So Abu Bakr al-Siddiq and Wardah, when he told the pagan go and suck the private part of the less who have the idols, they took it, khalas, Abu Bakr, there is a way Abu Bakr al-Siddiq said it in a time, you know, not just bring it and apply it to every situation and start mocking and so on. Na'am, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, Wardah, did Sahaba took it as manhaj? Ulama, I don't know which ulama, even though I have many books, alhamdulillah, about debating that was written by al-ilm, even by scholars of the past. I never come any scholar using that according to my knowledge, that when you're in a discussion with people and many people listen to you, you go say that. I mean, mocks the person and start acting like a clown. So being tough, being strong, you know, being, you know, stanch against a battle, yeah, there's no harm with that. Ibn Qayyim mentioned that in his kitab, Ar-Radd al-Jahmiyyah. So there is no problem with that. You know, he said, from al-mujadala, it turns to al-mujalada. Al-mujadala wal-mujalada. Al-mujadala debating now. Then it says, if you see stubborn, you become mujalid. Meaning you become harsh with him and strong with him. But be wise too. Be tough. So what you do, instead of try to explain Islam to him, if you notice he's start refuting his belief, exposing what he believes, that he has no leg to stand on. And that doesn't mean you're going off the topic, mean that this person is not going to listen to you, regardless of what you're going to tell him, he's well established being stubborn, then you expose his hypocrisy, his double standard. Do you understand? So you from Mujadala, you move on to Mujalada. No, from Mujadala, you move on to comedy show, to be clowned. No, that's not the way. Barakallahu feekum. And what I'm going to do, this Ali Dawah says, look, he's siding against the kuffar. This man is a khabith. You gave him a platform to mock Allah and his messenger. You gave him 2 hours, got all his stubborn, and you gave him the platform, al-iyadu billah, to his ahmaq. He's an enemy of Allah and his messenger. And he wants to spread doubt and lies against Islam. Guess what? Our Shaykh Abu Iyad Amjad Rafiq refuted this apostate liar, al-murtad an dinillah, this Iranian guy. Oh, is it Turkish or Iranian? Razwan, his name is Razwan. Turkish, yeah. Him, he exposed him, he lies. Intentionally, he lies. 4 years ago, I believe it was 4 years ago, 3 years ago. Alhamdulillah. So from Mujadala to Mujalada. So sometimes you can utilize a person, Shuhadami mentioned that, in a debate or discussion, you can utilize him. But the Salaf differ, I mean, not the differ, sorry. The Salaf made distinction between Al-Bida with Al-Bida and Al-Kitab. Because Allah said, وَجَادِلُ وَلَجَادُ أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ إِلَّا بِالَّتِي أَحْسَنُ. So Al-Kitab, as for people of Bida and innovations, upon them is a Taslim. سَمِعْنَا وَطَعْنَا. Because both of you Muslims, سَمِعْنَا وَطَعْنَا, except if the person is sincerely seeking the truth, or as Ibn Battah mentioned, likewise Al-Ajuri mentioned, Shaqabi mentioned that, if you're in a gathering and he's bringing doubt and you think people will affect by his doubt, then you refute him. If he challenges you from the people and you have ilm and knowledge, then you accept and expose him. As for organizing debates and sitting down and say, Barakallah fik Shaykhana, you're my teacher, we'll learn from you, from Ras Khawarij, then that is not the way of the Salaf. Barakallah fikum. So you don't know organize debate with Ahl Bidah. Naam, so there's we spoke about the types of, and there's praiseworthy one when the haqq wants the haqq to be established. You want the haqq to be established. And Shaykh Uthaymeen mentioned here, rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentioned about the same thing about debates. Into two. الأول أن يكون الغرض من ذلك إثبات الحق وإبطال الباطل وهذا مأمور بإما وجوبا أو استحبابا بحسب الحال. First one is to debate, to establish truth and refute a falsehood. That is something which is sometimes can be a compulsory upon the person to do it, or highly recommended, depends on the situation. As Allah said, ادعو إلى سبيل ربك بالحكمة والموعظة الحسنة وجادلهم بالتي هي أحسن. Call to the power of your Lord with wisdom and بالحكمة. الحكمة here is wisdom, but what does it mean? The meaning of it, Quran and Sunnah. As the Sheikh Abdullah al-Bukhari mentioned, حفظه تعالى, الحكمة هي means القرآن والسنة والموعظة الحسنة وجادلهم بالتي هي أحسن, and argue with them in that which is good. Another verse, إلا الذين ظلموا, except those who transgressed. Ibn Qayyim said, except those who transgressed, as I have mentioned previously, from مجادلة utensil مجالدة. And such as مجادلة mean also with fighting for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. من جهاد السيف. But also مجالدة mean to, in dialogue, you turn tough and strong and expose the opponent. This man's kadhab. He doesn't want the haqq. You know, so you're exposing him. And some Muslims, they think you're going off topic. No. You're not going off topic. You're exposing his hypocrisy, his double standard. Like an atheist coming to you, asking you about what person did or the Quran said this, kill. Atheist, he believes that we came from a random reaction. We are product of a random reaction of matter, blind matter, and a chemical reaction and so on. And he wants to speak about what is good, what is bad. That doesn't make any sense. And to him, there's nothing objective. Everything is subjective. Everything is according to our feelings. If you believe it's okay, then it's okay. So nothing is, they don't have a criteria. So instead of explaining to him, then you show him his hypocrisy. That you have nothing to stand on and you want to speak about Islam. Now, as for the other one, the one which, when there is just for the sake of showing off and so on, the other debate. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا يُجَادِلُ فِي آيَاتِهِ وَمَا يُجَادِلُ فِي آيَاتِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. Here it speaks about whom? Allah said, no other debates in Allah's verse except those who disbelieved. This debate, which is a blameworthy debate. The blameworthy debate. Brother Shaykh Uthaymeen, may Allah have mercy upon him, said, يَجِبُ عَلَى إِسْتَحِبُّ لِطَالِبِ الْعِلْمِ عَفْوًا إِسْتَحِبُّ لِطَالِبِ الْعِلْمِ أَنْ يُمَرِّنَ نَفْسَهُ عَلَى كَيْفِيَةِ إِقْنَاعِ الْمَدْعُو بِالْحُجَجِ وَالْبَرَاهِينِ وَكَيْفِيَةِ الْإِسْتِدْلَالِ وَإِسْتِحْضَارِ الدَّلِيلِ الْمُنَاسِبِ عَلَى الْمَسْأَلَةِ مُتَنَازِعَ عَلَيْهَا. He said, rather, it is recommended for a student of knowledge to teach himself and to train how to convince opponents with proofs and adilla and so on. Also, he mentioned, he said, لكن التمرن على المجادلة لإثبات الحق أمر لا بد منه. He said, rather, learning how to have a discussion and dialogue to establish truth. To establish truth, it is, it must be, we must do it. فكثير من الناس عنده علم واسع لكنه عند المجادلة يصعب إثبات. Some people, they have knowledge, but they don't know how to debate. And even Albani mentioned about one of the great scholars, Imam Muhammad Ibn Shinqiti. He said about, I have heard it with my own ears. You know, there's an audio. He said, Sheikh Muhammad Amin al-Shinqiti, he wrote a book, How to Debate. He wrote a book. But he doesn't know how to have debate, face to face. Subhanallah. So this, Fadl Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But some scholars, Sheikh al-Albani, he never studied mantaq. You know, the usul of debating, the burhan and so on. But he was... volcano in debate. Subhanallah. He was a volcano in debate. Because they say he was influenced by Ibn Hazm al-Zahiri. Ibn Hazm al-Zahiri was like that too. Ibn Hazm al-Hafidh, Ibn Hazm al-Zahiri. May Allah have mercy upon him. He was like that too. He was very strong in debates and discussion. But likewise, Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahu ta'ala. Ibn Taymiyyah, he was on a different level, man. Ibn Taymiyyah, as Ibn Daqiq al-Eid said, he said, Ibn Daqiq al-Eid, one of the ulama of Misr, may Allah have mercy upon him. He was a Shafi'i, yeah. Rahimahullah. He said, when he met Ibn Taymiyyah, he said, his eyes, like, he has two tongues. And he said, when he brings the proofs, as if he's looking at a book. Ibn Taymiyyah was different, you know, subhanAllah. He used to debate with Ahnaf, and he used to teach the Ahnaf ulama, aqwal from the Imam al-Ahnaf, which they never knew about. Likewise, al-Malikiyya and so on. When the Qadi of al-Malikiyya tried to put him in prison because of something, he said, according to your madhab, that is incorrect. According to your madhab, because at that time they were mutaassib al-madhab. They were blind followers to madhab. They don't ta'assub. The shahid, that subhanAllah, Shaykh Islam Shaykh Uthaymeen said the same thing. So, teach. That's why Shaykh Uthaymeen, if you listen to his talk, you can hear him like debating. Discussion. The discussion, debate, dialogue. Because why is the mujadala? Mujadala, when you pull, linguistically, you pull, he pulls. So you give and take. Shaykh Uthaymeen was good, rahmahu ta'ala. But Shaykh Albani was different. Shaykh Albani, if you want, Shaykh Albani, may Allah have mercy upon him, he does not let you go off topic. Just forget it. He's not in need of your life story. He is not in need of that. You listen to him, يقول حتى حتى. I mean, you digress. And he's not going to let you go. He's not going to let you go. Because why? If he brings, when you have a discussion with someone, if he brings another point, then he brings what? Another point. So you start chasing like a rabbit from one hole to another hole. From one hole, then you can never catch him. You know, that's why we have to stick. Something happens with human nature, forget. You want to clarify everything in 1 minute. But we have to learn, all of us, to stick. And we are talking about debate and discussion. I'm not saying go open a YouTube channel or go speaker's corner Sunday and start debating. No, it's not like that. May Allah bless you all. And the us of our da'wah is not debate. Us of da'wah is to learn and study and go to Ahl al-Ilm, travel. That's our da'wah, Salafiyya. Na'am. Yes, when you give da'wah to non-Muslims, of course, you're not going to tell him Allah said, na'am, khalas, you're Muslim. He's not Muslim. But use the adilla and the sunnah. طيب, the intellectual proofs of the Quran and the Sunnah. Okay, what about the hadith of أنا زعيم ببيت في ربض الجنة لمن ترك المراء وإن كان محقا? What about the hadith of Rasim said, I will be the guarantor of a person that will leave off debate, mean he will have a place in Jannah. He will guarantee you will have a place, Rasul guarantee you will have a place in Jannah, in the middle of Jannah, if you leave off debating and discussion, even if you are truthful. Even if the truth is with you, if you leave off debate, then you have, Rasul said, for definitely you have a place in Jannah, the middle of Jannah. Shaykh Uthaymeen said the meaning of the hadith here, لأنه, in the issue that which is not needed to establish truth. For example, me and the brother Jamal speaking. He said, no, brother Jamal was doing this. I said, no, brother Jamal was doing that. And we start arguing and debating. If it's a khalas, okay, you're right. There's no need, okay, he was doing this. Where is it shared? You know, or something like, there's no need. Do you understand? It's not about establishing the truth. If you stop speaking, al-haq sawfa yudhi' aw yadhi', that the truth is going to be lost. So the Salaf did warn against debating and having discussions with Al-Bida' with Dalalat, those stubborn ones. And especially in the beginning, when they've noticed that, because sometimes Bida' can be spread through debate. The Bida' is not known. The innovation is not known, then you go debate. That's why Imam Ad-Dari, may Allah have mercy upon him, in his Radd, Ala Bishl Marisi, he said the reason he has written the book to refute Bishl Marisi because the Bida' became widespread. Awam starts getting influenced. That's why he wrote the book. Like in our time, Shubha is everywhere. You cannot. Now, subhanAllah, the social media is being used to spread Shubhat. You know, some issues you don't want to discuss. You think people don't know it, people are not ready for it. Our time is different. Some young guy, brothers and sisters, the issues they speak about, the discussions they have about Islam and Aqidah and so on. Hey, brother, so subhanAllah, it's like a very, very advanced issues. So now, subhanAllah, it's not like before. And now, even the kuffar, they bring doubt against Islam and Adabillah because of social media. But again, the asr, just to emphasize, the asr is to teach, to learn, and study, and you know, it's just all the time debate. Yeah, you give da'wah, of course, giving da'wah, and discussion, there's no problem with that. You know, as long as you have knowledge, of course, as long as you have knowledge. But sometimes, like, speaking to the same person, he's going to bring the same thing. Yes, exception to it, if you're going to utilize him to spread the truth. Now, and he says here about not sitting with the people of desires, not to sit with the people of desires. There's many athar of the Salaf warning against sitting with the people of bid'ah, of innovations. So he said from the usul, so what is it? This one is from the usul of Al-Sunnah al-Jama'ah. Not like this brother from Birmingham, may Allah guide us and guide him. This person. He's saying, the Salaf, you are blind for a Salaf. Imam Ahmed is not saying he got it from your, from a newspaper or something. It's from usul of Al-Sunnah. These who have the Sahaba. People, innovation is guidance. You stay away from them. You do not sit with them. This is because most of the time, sitting with the people from misguidance leads to deviation. Many people are deceived by their knowledge and intelligence. Consequently, they intermingle and live with the people. They will mix with them and live with the people of innovation. As a result, Allah leaves them to themselves, and they follow into misguidance. This scenario is real and tangible. Imam ibn Battah pointed this out when he said, so sitting with people of innovation, misguidance, can lead you, a'udhu billah, to how many people? They were with us. They were with people of sunnah, hadith, and athar. Step by step, they left the brothers, left al-hadith al-athar, al-sunnah, salafiyun. Then he starts sitting with the people who try to water down salafiyah. From watering down Salafiyah, him, he thinks, no, they're not watering down more enough. Let me water down more enough. Then he sees him, Khariji. Look this, Yasir al-Fadi. Yasir al-Fadi. He was with the Salafis, but even that, they said, even before, because alhamdulillah, our brothers in Maktab al-Salafiyah went and guessed him in 2000. And why it's funny, when you hear brother Dawah, a man, Ibn Mansur, he said he's first person to want and guess Yes, Qadi. I don't know. Are you older than Abu Iyad or something? How? Abu Iyad, there were 2,000. I think the brother was maybe 5 years or two, six, 7 years. You know, he didn't even know about Salafiyah. They went and guessed him, alhamdulillah. They spoke out. And alhamdulillah, the brothers, Maktab al-Salafiyah, mashallah, the brothers, the people they spoke out against and refuted, you know, of the Makhi. Claim is guided, alhamdulillah. You can see them. So, you see with Al-Bida. Ibn Battah mentioned, we knew a people who used to insult and curse the people of innovation. But then they began to sit and live with them. Then they became from them. Rather, they became worse than them on us. Why? Because sitting with them, say, why are you harsh? You know, don't be harsh, yes. Kalimatu haqqin urida biha batil. Yes, don't be harsh. It's true. Be soft. No doubt about that. But, is it? It's not blocked, is it? It's okay. But, the problem is, some people, they mix between advising and hanging around people with that. Advising doesn't mean you mix with them. Yes, you advise. If you have knowledge, you advise them. And so on. As for the awam, be nice to them. Be soft with them. Be patient with them. Especially our time. But that doesn't mean you sit and listen to their doubts, their shubuhats, their misconceptions. We don't mix between the two. Barakallahu feekum. Look what Ibn Battah, may Allah have mercy upon him, mentioned. So this situation is reality in every time and place. This situation is a reality in every time and place. Some major individuals, even our times, were deceived by themselves. So sadly, they fell into innovation. We don't want to mention their names. They are one known amongst the students of knowledge. Sheikh Rabi is mentioning some people, they fell into al-bid'ah wal-iyadu billah. So there's many athar from the Sahaba. Alhamdulillah. يهديكم الله يصلح بالكم. So there's ayah. وإذا رأيت الذين يخوضون في آياتنا فأعرض عنهم حتى يخوضوا في حديث غيره. When you see Muhammad والسلام, those who engage in a false conversation about our verses of the Quran by mocking at them, stay away from them until they turn to another topic. Do not sit with them, because these people engage in a false conversation about the verse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet said, there will be a people from my ummah. They will come to you with that which neither you or your forefathers were aware of. So be aware of them. Be aware of them. Ibn Abbas, may Allah please with him, warned from sitting with the people of innovation and desires. Also, many of the major scholars of the generation which followed the companions, such as Ayyub al-Sakhtiyani, Ibn Sirin, may Allah have mercy upon them. Naam, like Imam Ahmed rahimahu ta'ala. You know, Imam Ahmed rahimahu ta'ala, do you know how many people spoke against? Likewise, Imam al-Bukhari. Imam Bukhari, ilm al-hadith, هذا ضعيف, هذا كذاب, هذا كذا, هذا كذا. In our time, maybe they call him مدخلي. As I say, this one مدخلي. They were calling مدخلي. Subhanallah. How many people he spoke? Rather, Ibn Hibban has a book called Al-Majruhin. Those who have been criticized in a book of Du'afa. And those people, they spoke against, they are Muslims. They are Muslims, ya ikhwa. So were they backbiting? Imam Bukhari was backbiting, miskin. So you have more taqwa than Imam al-Bukhari, may Allah have mercy upon Imam Ahmed al-Hanbal. No, because they were doing it for the sake of defending the deen of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imam Ahmed rahimahu wa ta'ala, ستجنبوا أصحاب الجدال والكلام عليكم والكلام عليكم بالسنن وما كان عليه أهل العلم قبلكم فإنهم كانوا يكرهون الكلام والخوض في أهل البدع والجلوس معهم وإنما السلام في ترك هذا. So Imam Ahmed, may Allah have mercy upon him, said, stay away from people of argumentation, the blameworthy one, or those who just want to debate for the sake of debating, not seeking the truth. Well, kalam, people of kalam. Kalam not mean speaking. If you want to speak, you know, as Ibn Taymiyyah mentioned. No, kalam mean the people like Muhammad Hijab and so on. People of kalam. Like kalam, falsafa. No, qal Allah, qal al-Rasul, alayhi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No. The al-kalam, Ibn Sina and al-Farabi style. Stay away from them. Don't listen to them. Stay away from them. وَالْخَوْضُ فِي عَلَيْكُمْ إِيشْ بِالسُّنَنِ with the advice of the Salaf. Where did he take this advice from? From his pocket? No, from the Qur'an, the Sunnah. عَلَيْكُمْ بِالسُّنَنِ follow the Sunnah of Mustafa alayhi salatu wasalam. وَمَا كَانَ عَلَيْهِ أَهْلِ الْعِلْمِ قَبْلَكُمْ and to be upon the way of the people of knowledge before us. Mean the companions and those who follow them in goodness. بارك الله فيكم. قد أجمع السلف على التحذير من أهل البدع. Salaf agreed to warn against أهل البدع. And listen to his story, my brothers. May Allah bless you all. Likewise, my sisters. The story of Sabir. Sabir, he was a young boy. He came to Medina. He was going around bringing, speaking about unclear verses, without ilm, bringing doubt, misconceptions. Umar ibn Khattab, Allah please with him, brought him over. He said, he was looking for him. Then he brought him. He said, man anti, ana Sabir Abdullah. He said, wa ana Umar Abdullah. So he hit him in his head. He hit him then. Then one said, ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, if you want to remove that which was in my head before, then it has been removed, alhamdulillah. If you want to kill me, just kill me, or something like that. So he let him go and he said, don't sit with him. For a year or 2 years. Afterwards, when the Khawarij emerged, they came to him and they told him, it is your time to shine. Sabir, it is your time to shine. He said, no, Umar taught me a lesson. He said, no more. You know, look, subhanallah. So Umar ibn Khattab, this narration is not there in me. قال فضيل بن عياد رحمه الله من جلس صاحب بدعة لم يعطى الحكمة. Anyone that sits with people of innovation, the hikmah will be removed from him. Because if he has a hikmah, he will not be sitting with people of bidah. If you have hikmah, which is hikmah, هي الحكمة مبنية على القرآن والسنة, you will not be sitting with people of bidah and hang around with them. You be said Al Sunnah, and we mentioned there's difference between advising, being nice, respectful to those who are seeking the truth. And sometimes if a person being stubborn here and then, be patient more. Because some people take some time to stop what they are upon. Especially our time. The people of our time different than before. Sheikh Ibn Baz, he mentioned even before. So you have to be patient with the people. But use hikmah, and you know, you can see some people, he wants to learn, but some stuff still with him. So it takes time to learn and takes time for him to turn away from those ideologies or those manhaj or the manhaj. Can you be, you have some sabr with him, some patience with him, speak to him nicely, try to invite him to your house for food, you know? But if you notice this person is being a snake, how? So you're nice to him, and he says, yeah, I'm listening. Like what Suleiman was doing to us in Speaker's Corner, I mean Anwar, who advising him, and his name, Abdul Hakim. May Allah guide us and guide him. I mean, that we speak to him in private, and he says, yeah, he said to Anwar, it makes sense, what he says is true. Then he was going behind our backs and tried to spread the aqid of the Khawarij to young brothers in Speaker's Corner. That's why we had to expose him, because why? He's been a snake here. So if he comes to Masjid, someone that you know in the Masjid he comes, you advise him, be nice to him, don't abandon him from the Masjid. We don't abandon no one to come, except if someone coming to cause trouble. If he's coming to cause trouble, yeah, you're allowed to abandon him, to abandon the person from the Masjid, as the ulama have mentioned. If it's a troublemaker, causing mashaykh, bringing doubt about the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Na'am. And he said, do not save people of innovation, because I fear the la'na, the curse, will be sent down upon you. Because Prophet Sallam cursed three times people. One of them, the one that will accommodate Sahib Bid'ah in Medina. So people, they think the Aqwal al-Salaf, they just go from their pockets. Like this brother from Birmingham, Miskin. You know, he focuses, no, it's based upon Quran and Sunnah. It's been derived from the Quran and Sunnah and the Aqwal of the Sahaba. May Allah please with him, with them. وقال أبو قلابة يا أيوب, he's referring to أيوب السختياني, لا تمكن أصحاب الأهواء من سمعيك. He said, don't let the people of misguidance throw doubt into your ears. وقال فضيل بن عياد, إذا رأيت مبتدعا في طريق فخذ في طريق آخر. If you see someone of بدعة in one way, take the other way. And this is not any person, like Awam mentioned. And also there's a hikmah to implement this athar. There's a hikmah and there's a way. I'm someone from the head of Al-Bida'. Me personally, if I see him, I cross the road. The head of Al-Bida'. You don't want to walk from this who is destroying Islam from within. But there's hikmah. You know how to utilize it. You know how to use it. He's not talking about anyone. Barakallahu feekum. Like Ammi, you had a discussion with from the Khawarij, his effect by Khawarij mentality or Asha'ira. Then you see him walk away. No. Especially our time is sabr. Sheikh Rabi' he said, if we start boycotting everyone, who are you going to give da'wah to? Who? No one. What, to us, to each other? Huh? No, you have to be patient, ikhwah. And soft and nice, respectful, you know, alhamdulillah. But if you notice the person is stubborn, he's stubborn, not just stubborn, he's doing it and spreading his misguidance, then there's a way to deal with him. And alhamdulillah, look, people lie, I guess, as I say, they're harsh, they boycott everyone. No, these people are liars. They will lie against Al-Sunnah Jama'ah. Look, Ali Da'wah, he used to cooperate with his brother from America. He spoke out against him about the debate. He said, he's aiding the kuffar against the Muslims. He's not. The brother, there's some issues with him. But we're speaking the truth. He's not aiding. He's speaking the truth. He knows that guy is misguided, liar, evil. But these guys, Ali and Muhammad, they lie. They accuse Muslims of zina. They accuse Muslims of stealing. They accuse Al-Sunnah Jama'ah of many things. And they're harsh. No, alhamdulillah. I mean, love you here. You're very new here, this masjid. You know, alhamdulillah, were we harsh with you? Did we use a baseball bat or something to make you bring you here? Go outside, bring you in? Alhamdulillah. You know, rather we love our brothers and sisters in Islam. And we know, love us. And many brothers and sisters have been influenced by the aqid of the Khawarij or other aqid of Al-Bida'. So So because of the environment and because of jahl, so we be patient with the people. Like people were patient with us. So we are patient with the people. So there's many athar from the aim of Salaf about certain people of innovation misguidance. But like I said, you have to know how to implement it and we have to understand it correctly because there is a group that misunderstood this athar. Who are they? Al-Haddadiyya. Atba' Mahmoud al-Haddad. He was an Egyptian man who moved to Saudi and he was causing fitna. And he said, let's burn Fath al-Bari because Ibn Hajar had some mistakes in Aqidah. Let's burn Shrah Imam al-Nawawi. Shrah Imam Muslim, Imam al-Nawawi, because Nawawi had some mistakes in Aqidah. When you mention Abu Hassan al-Ash'ari, don't say Rahimahullah, that's what they say. Even some of them, subhanAllah, they go and make takfir on Imam Abu Hanifa. Because yes, some staff did make takfir on Imam Abu Hanifa. That's some kitab, Sunnah Imam Abi Abd al-Rahman, Abdullah bin Ahmed bin Hanbal. But some stuff that was said about Imam Abu Hanifa was not true. And some of it, he took it back. And some of it, which irja, he was from the murji'a of al-fuqaha. May Allah have mercy upon him. However, he's from the a'imma of al-sunnah al-jama'a. His madhab is from the madhab of al-sunnah al-jama'a. But some people, akhi, there is even called Abu Jifa. Wal-iyadu billah. There's no tarbiyah of our a'imma. There's no tarbiyah of the scholars of our time. They don't belittle Imam Abu Hanifa, rahmahu ta'ala. He was a great imam. May Allah have mercy upon him. Abu Hanifa al-Nu'man. And as the Sheikh Fawzi mentioned, because he was in Kufa, and the Kufa was full of Shia, so he was scared of narrations because there were a lot of lies, you know, around the area. May Allah have mercy upon him. So yeah, we say, na'am, some self did warn against him and so on, because some stuff was true about him, but he took it back. Some stuff was not true, was a lie. And something which he never took it back, some irja. But his irja is not the worst irja of the Jahmiyyah wal Karramiyyah and so on. Barakallahu feekum. So we love Imam Abu Hanifa, he's from the imma, and he's from the madhab that if you follow it, there is no harm. Because from the madhab al-Sunnah al-Jama'ah, rather there's many scholars from the Salaf, and after the Salaf, they were Ahnaf. Naam, so the Haddadiyya, they went to extreme. Like, for example, the man that he saw and he slept, Mubtadi, he don't go do it. This specific situation happened in the time of Salaf. You know, so we have to be wise. You have to understand this athar correctly. Barakallahu feekum. Now, and we stop here, inshallah ta'ala. The next one will be Manzilat Sunnah wa alaqatuha bil Quran. And the Sunnah with us are narration or the states of the Sunnah and its relationship with Quran. You know, Sunnah wal Quran. Not like so-called Quraniyun. Because Sunnah, he said, and the Sunnah with us are narration or narrations of the Messenger of Allah. It is the tafsir and the clarification of the Quran. There is no analogy in the Sunnah. And an example should not be placed for it. Allahu Akbar. You don't see how, when you read the books of the Salaf, Rahimahum Allah, Ta'zim al-Sunnah, Al-Quran wa-Sunnah, when you read the books of Aqaid of Asha'im, other than them, subhanAllah, ya akhi. Al-Aql, you know, was the first thing upon the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is another word, istidlal. Some of them, some ulama Asha'ira, they're not like, not all of them are the same, there's different types. But the Shahid looks at the books of the Salaf. You know what is calamity? There's this YouTube channel, Hanafi something YouTube channel, and they claim that we rely on their scholars for hadith. As Ibn Rajab was Ash'ari. And Ibn Hajar was not Ash'ari because the Asha'ira have principles, has usul. There's different, my brothers and sisters, may Allah bless all. Someone who's asl Quran and Sunnah, going back to the Salaf, and fall into mistakes. And someone usul is usul mubtada'a. Ibn Hajar Asqalani, when Nawawi, their usul is not the usul of Asha'ira. Their usul is Quran al-Sunnah. That's why you see they come back to Quran al-Sunnah and the way of the Salaf. However, they made some mistakes here and there. And our ulama, they clarified and refuted those mistakes. Subhanallah. Sheikh Rabi has a book refuting the akhta of Ibn Hajar in Fath al-Bari, in Aqidah. That shows you the ulama do not compromise. He's a alim, big imam, rahimahu ta'ala, but we correct his mistakes. No, I'm saying we, doesn't mean me. Yeah. So you are the ulama. Our ulama, may Allah bless them and have mercy upon those who have passed away, they correct it. Now, that will be next week, inshallah ta'ala. Wa sallallahu ala imamina wa qurrati a'yuna Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in wa sallam salima kathira.